Hello everyone, and welcome back to my YouTube page, Adam Stargazing Astrology. Thanks so much for watching. So I hope everyone is doing great out there so far this summer, and I am going to be pulling up the astrological chart for now, and then just telling everyone a little bit about some of the dynamics that are going on, so we can get a little better view of what we have to look forward to right now. All right, everyone. So here is the astrology chart going on for right now. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to circle some things and just talk about some of these aspects going on here. So if you could please bear with me for one second here. Okay, here we go. So the first aspect I'm going to be talking about is this one right here that I'm circling. So this planet right here is Mars. This planet is Uranus. So Mars indicates Mars is the god of war, and Mars indicates our energy. Mars indicates also our ego assertion and how we go about doing things. So when Mars, which represents energy and ego assertion, is sitting so close to the planet Uranus, which is all about volatility, this could make for some volatile emotions. Uranus sitting next to Mars is definitely can be explosive. Think of the analogy of something having to do with like a ticking time bomb. Uranus energies are very unpredictable. Mars energies are very explosive and fiery. So this could also indicate more widespread fires like we're seeing as well. So Mars, right, is sitting here at 20 degrees. Uranus is at 26. So over the course of the next couple of weeks, Mars is going to be moving closer and closer, as represented by those little arrows, to that planet Uranus. And when it moves closer and closer like that, it's going to be more of a forceful energy. So the best thing to do nowadays is to avoid the Mars energy having to do with conflict, having to do with battle, because we do not want to perpetuate things like accidents and upsets. There is enough of that. So this is going to play out probably pretty nasty on the political spectrum. Mars throws, Mars representing our energy. Mars also represents the god of war. So Mars is kind of at battle here. And there's a lot of unpredictability going on. The best thing we could do is just understand what's going on with these energies and try not to let them take us over. This is a challenging aspect here. Okay, so the next aspect going on here is we still have the Jupiter. I'm going to circle that right here. Jupiter represents our gifts. So Jupiter in Gemini represents gifts having to do with reading and writing and communications. So right now, if there's any writing projects you're doing, any reading projects, Gemini also rules short trips. So this is a wonderful time right now to go on short trips with that Jupiter in Gemini. Gemini is also a sign of curiosity and learning, and Jupiter represents the way we expand. So right now is also a wonderful time to be learning some sort of new project, some sort of hobby. So this is definitely Cancerian season right now. The Sun and Venus are in the sign of Cancer. So the Cancerian is energy is very watery. It's somewhat inward. Great time for creativity, for nurturing individuals, for children, for self-reflection as well. Cancer rules the emotional undercurrents of the home and family dynamics. So right now is a wonderful time to heal and release unconscious wounds from early childhood dynamics. Also a great time to be able to just hang out with friends and to enjoy family as well. So that's the sun sign. Venus in Cancer tends to be very nurturing. Venus represents our value system. Venus represents finances to a certain extent, and it also represents the way in which we harmonize and socialize with others. Venus is a planet of harmony. So when harmonization, as represented by Venus, is in the sign Cancer, those Cancerian qualities tend to be more harmonized, and that can make for a nice period of a really happy and harmonious family situation. So Mercury is sitting right next to there is the Leo sign, which is getting a little squished out, but I just circled it here and I'll point to that. So Leo is really all about self-expression, play, creativity. Leo is the externalization of the self, and Mercury is communication. So Leo and Mercury would be something like going karaoke. Leo tends to be more social. Cancer and Leo are signs that really have to do with family and kids. So again, I can't say this enough, wonderful time for family vacations. So let's see here. The planet Pluto, which represents those power structures, is still in a retrograde position, that little R right there. So Pluto in retrograde is reviewing power dynamics, reviewing power structures. Pluto has again moved into Aquarius. Again, that Pluto in Aquarius, as I mentioned before, is tends to be more democratic. However, Pluto is such a slow moving planet, slow around, you know, around the chart, that we really don't see the influences overnight. We will really see the Pluto and Aquarius influence in the next several years. We'll see a big upward trajectory with that. So that is something good to look forward to as far as, you know, those more democratic ideals. The planet Saturn right here is in that retrograde position as well. So Saturn represents the Lord of Karma. It's a balancing act. What we sow is what we reap with Saturn. So retrograde is all about review. So during the retrograde time, it's generally not a great time to start things, but more time to review, revise, refinish, rethink. So if any of those ring a bell, this is a wonderful time to do that with the Saturn retrograde. Also, where individuals have stepped out of bounds, there can be a bit of sort of a revision in order to try to get that individual maybe back on, or individuals back on a line of integrity. So the North Node and the South Node, they're always opposite. So those have been in Aries and Cancer for a while. Here's Aries. So the North Node is our evolutionary direction of progression. So the North Node in Aries is really all about independent action, courage, strength, self-willed activity. That South Node in Libra is all about harmonizing relationships. So the South Node stands for our foundation. So it's really important that as a foundational kind of way of being, that our relationships are harmonious and that we have good support with relationships, so we can spring back into that North Node, which is really all about moving forward. Now, as you can see here, the aspect grid, which is in the middle, represented by these blue lines and the red lines, all that. See a lot of blue lines. Blue lines stand for sextiles and trines, which are harmonious aspects in between planets. Those represent, I call trines the gifts of God. They represent grace. They represent creativity, enhanced understanding, being able to kind of connect the dots. Sextiles, which is the which is basically a trine cut in half. It's really the ability for creative opportunities, and the ability to be able to sort of open our eyes to a new way of being and a new way of looking at things. So those are also very exciting as well. The red lines, those are squares and oppositions. We all have those. So they're not bad. I don't want to say good and bad. Square aspects can really create a lot of drive. So what we see here is there's some square aspects. There's one between the sun sign. For example, there's a sun sign and a kind of a loose square to the North Node. So, you know, the sun sign represents ego structure, vitality. Anytime you see a square aspect, there's a drive and there's a focus. There can also be a drama. So, you know, for example, the sun sign squared the North Node. Sun in a square aspect, there could be issues around ego. There can be issues around vitality, around health, because that's the sun sign that maybe is not letting you like really move forward how you want to move forward, as representation by that North Node in Aries. So squares, they act as stumbling blocks. They have to act as obstacles, and they can create crisis and challenge, hopefully for us to overcome and to create a greater awareness through those challenges. The whole idea is to swim as opposed to sink. So there is just a real combination. Overall, I actually see more blue lines, which represent more of creativity and grace and ease, as opposed to the harsh lines. A big dynamic, a big one though that I do want to talk about is Pluto right here. It's in an oppositional aspect as represented by this red line. Sorry, you guys, I'm doing so many anyways, I'm just kind of messing everything up here. But this big red line right here, I'll sort of draw an arrow right here. So that this one, there we go. So it's in an oppositional aspect to the Mercury. And I'll just tell you what that is. Mercury stands for communications. So Pluto represents power dynamics. Oppositions can be intense, they can be confrontational. So there could be some intense confrontations around power dynamics as far as the spoken word, power trays, plays, power trips, stuff like that. So that's probably one of the most challenging aspects that's going on right now. Individuals and potential power trips. So that's something that we're going to have to watch. And the last thing is the planet Neptune right here. I'll draw a little arrow. Neptune went in a retrograde aspect as well. So what does this mean? So Neptune is the god of the sea, and Neptune represents our spirituality, our connection to the universe, our creativity. It also rules dreams, but it can also rule things like charlatans, illusions, delusions, confusions, heightened intuition. So whenever Neptune goes into retrograde, those energies get turned inward. So what happens is our we can have more profound dreams, and there could be psychic receptivity to things that may happen in the future. So there can be clairvoyancy that can get sort of amped up with a Neptune in retrograde aspect. However, that being said, our spirituality and our inner life can get ramped up, but unfortunately, with this also can come up, illusions, delusions, things like that can also get heightened during this Neptune retrograde as well, and escapism. So that is something to watch out for. Neptune in retrograde, it's a slow-moving aspect, so it's going to be in there at least several months. So that is something to definitely pay a close eye on. So let me see here. So I'm just kind of wrapping up the video here. So those are basically the main aspects that are going on. And I do hope that everyone has enjoyed my video of some of the interpretation of what's going on now. And again, I'm offering discounted astrological readings of all types. So if you're at any crossroads in your life, any questions around relocation, travel, health, and anything having to do with just wanting to know your own birth chart, finances, any aspect of life, astrology is a wonderful tool in helping enhance understanding and jump over stumbling blocks. All right, everyone, have a great day, and thanks so much for watching. Bye.